gangs up. What did he say? And I said, he said no.
With the record company unwilling to pay the $500,000 budget for the Thriller video, the project seemed dead in the water. But John and his team came up with a solution. They'd produce a making-of documentary and sell that to fund the film. The making of Thriller was a unique behind-the-scenes look at the most successful pop star in the world. It became the biggest-selling home video released of all time. In one of the most fascinating sequences, Rick Baker is filmed preparing Michael for his transformation into a monster.
John surprised me. I thought I was going to be taking a life cast of Michael that day, and I didn't know there was going to be a camera crew there. And I said, you know, John, come on. You know, I mean, it's this, you know, Michael, you know, is obviously shy. You know, this, it always looks horrifying when you show somebody to get a life cast taken.
Yeah.
Do we really need to do this? You know, and yes.
John says, you know. Yes.
Now, in hindsight, I'm so thankful that they did do the making of Thriller because it inspired a lot of people to become makeup artists.
Was you involved creatively from the tip top, what characters were going to be in the video and how they were going to look?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. I really didn't want to do another werewolf, so to speak. And I thought it'd be cool to do him as more feline, like a cat, you know. And he went for it. We did it with his bladders under his appliance, with his brow and his cheekbones growing. I think we shot most of the transformation in one day at my shop. We had stuff in the hands and the inserts and all that stuff. And the whiskers coming out was a head that was just like a half a head of Michael that we made. We punched the hairs through this thing and then we pulled them in and then reverse printed it so it looked like they were growing.
Oh, so it looked like they were growing. That's cool.
There's a lot of, you know, tricks. You know, we didn't have computers and things in those days, you know. And I happened to have brought the teeth that Michael Jackson wore when he was the cat monster.
These are the actual teeth?
Yeah. I'm sure there's some of his DNA right in these teeth right here. So.
Can I have a look?
Sure. Just don't drop them.
These are actually, it's a little scary.
Yeah.
These are
well, they're
scary.
Sharp, too, and I was worried about that. I was afraid...
Would have won that biting you.
Yeah, I was just afraid of Michael, like, biting his lip, you know, or, like, falling
in the middle of it. Obviously, he had the two characters. He had, like, the cat kind of character, and then, obviously, the zombie. Now, when Michael turned into the zombie, it was incredible how much he still looked like Michael, but yet he looked completely different. How did you go about creating that look, that zombie look?
It was really to make more skull-like cheekbones and eye sockets, you know, and... But he was up for it. He really, you know, he really wanted to wear these makeups.
The making of documentary reveals John Landis's skillful direction of Michael Jackson as he flirts with his screen girlfriend, played by former Playboy model Ola Ray.